Today, I messed up by accidentally revealing my boyfriend's mom's infidelity. Obligatory. The story actually happened about a year ago. I, 18 female at the time, was dating a boy named Jacob, 18 male at the time. His father, early 60s, was a mechanic, and his mom, mid-50s, was a stay-at-home mom. They were a pretty typical white suburban family in the South, and had asked Jacob if they could meet me even though we had only been dating for a month. At the dinner, I met his mom, dad, older brother, older sister, and her newborn daughter. The dinner went well, and I was chatting about my volunteer work at my college's blood drive, to which his father explains that his doctor told him he was O negative and a universal blood donor. My boyfriend mentions he is also O, but his siblings casually mentioned they are both AB. I don't think anything of it because my boyfriend had mentioned that his mom was married once before and was widowed. The following conversations went like this. Me: oh, that's really cool. You're a really rare blood type. If you don't mind me asking, is your mom's blood type A and your dad's B, or your dad's A and mom's B? Older sister: what do you mean? He is O. Gesturing to my boyfriend's father. Me: oh, I know. I was just asking about your bio father. But of course you don't have to answer if you don't want to. I then noticed his mom getting really pale. And it was in that moment I realized I messed up. Older brother: what do you mean bio father? Me: I'm sorry, I didn't mean anything by it. Jacob's dad got really quiet, and looking at his wife's face, he knew instantly. I look over to Jacob, who I think was starting to put the full picture of what was happening together. Jacob's dad: are you saying they're not my biological kids? Because my wife swore up and down in marriage counseling, by marriage counseling they mean with a pastor, that they were my kids and she would never cheat on me. Yeah, turns out she never had any kids from her previous marriage. Jacob's mom: I would never cheat on you. Older sister and older brother are your kids. Jacob's dad: OP, why do you think they're not my kids? I tried to excuse myself because it was very clear the cat was out of the bag. And with a quick Google search for my boyfriend, he starts cussing out his mom. She starts to sob and apologizes over and over again. But I am forced to explain 9th grade biology to his father about the fact that the only kids he could have produced were with the blood type O, A or B. But absolutely not AB. So Jacob was the only one with the possibility of being a son. They all start screaming at one another. Older sister eventually leaves because her newborn is screaming too. His mom goes and locks herself in the bedroom. But his older brother follows her screaming, asking who his real father is. My boyfriend is trying to figure out if his dad still wants to be their father. And I eventually have a friend come pick me up. Yeah, we broke up shortly after. But not after figuring out that none of the kids produced from the marriage was his. They found out via paternity tests, and for sure weren't his kids, and they divorced soon after. Edit: for those asking how they knew their blood types, Jacob donated blood for the blood drive at our school. His sister just had a baby, so she was probably informed during pregnancy. Jacob's dad was told by his doctor for, probably, underlying medical reasons, I don't know. I wasn't ever really close to his family after that for obvious reasons. And I don't know how his brother knew. Now for the top comments. That's an amazing life experience. Not many people get to be the catalyst for a family disintegrating by holding an impromptu high school science lecture. Wicked. I second this. It may have felt uncomfortable in the moment, but knowing science and explaining it to people who don't know science is never a screw-up. This is exactly why our bio class stopped having the students compare their blood to their parents' blood for labs. Apparently, there was always one kid every year who was not biologically connected to the dad. I wonder how many people will actually see a family implode. You had a front row seat. What do you mean front row seat? This lucky slash unlucky lady was driving. Steered headfirst into the family, then got out of the car and ran away unscathed. Damn, all his kids weren't his after 18 years? Yeah, that might break me. Legitimately break me. Definitely would still love the crap out of my kids, but I think something would break inside me. The knowing that my entire reproductive life, due to 60, is a lie and the opportunity to father biological kids is long past. I couldn't talk to my soon-to-be ex-spouse again. Then I would need some therapy. I found out right around the time my little princess turned 1 year old. I had some doubts beforehand, but didn't pursue it because I was scared of the truth. Turns out she wasn't mine, and it truly did break me and put me into a dark self-ending place in my life that I'm thankful I made it out of. There's nothing more devastatingly heart-wrenching than finding out a child whom you love so much is not yours. She's now 5 years old, and she will always be my princess and my daughter to me, no matter who or what anyone says. Her real father is in her life now, but she still calls me daddy. I have an older daughter too that is for sure my blood, and they are sisters. So I will always be part of her life and will never turn my back on her for her mother's infidelity. None of this was her fault. She is an innocent child, and she is nothing short of a blessing to me regardless of blood. Next story is titled, My 22 female dad, 50 male, found out my brother, 13 male, isn't his, and is demanding that I participate in a paternity test. My brother has been having serious medical issues. I don't want to get into details, but in the midst of one of his hospitalizations, it was found out my brother is not my dad's son. My dad was devastated. I left the house and went radio silent for a lot of days. My mom, 47 female, knew that I was bound to talk to her sometime soon, so she admitted that she had an affair with a boss when she started working for him at age 23 and stopped working for him at 35 when he retired. The man died a few years ago, and my mom said she was sure that I was my father's child. My dad pretty much told everybody in the extended family about what we found out, so things were already starting to become a war with relatives saying their pieces. Their separation got even more bitter when my mom decided to be the one to serve divorce papers on my dad. From what I got out of the two of them, my mom thought my dad was going to punish my brother by denying him funds for medical care, and she said for him, she needed to be the one to say her piece first. I've tried to reach out to my dad and offer him my emotional support. I noticed he was looking unkempt and looked to not be eating well, so I offered to go stock up his apartment with the groceries. I also offered my financial support because I was grateful he put me through Vanderbilt. Even though we're not rich or upper middle class, but I've gotten a good job in finance and good paying internships because of it. He's been cold about all my overtures and would use our calls to rant about every aspect of his life. He yelled at me through the phone once when I mentioned that my brother said he missed my dad and sends his love. It has been hell, especially because I feel like I have to take sides. My parents' credit is terrible due to medical bills and other expenses, but if I give money to my mom, then I'll be favoring her over my dad, and I'm of course mad at my mom for hurting my dad. My dad called me the other day. It's one of the few times he called me instead of the other way around, and he said that he thinks that he has to know, so he was asking me if I'd go with him to take a paternity test. He told me that he always thought it didn't look like him, but my brother out of us two looked more like him. He texted me about this many times after his call. I have to be honest, I want a good relationship with my dad again, and I know if it turns out I am his daughter that it would improve. But I'm afraid of the alternative, and I don't know if I want to know. And my dad also admitted he doesn't know if he wants to know sometimes either. But let's just get it over with, even if the results will hurt us. What do I do? I'm afraid we'll both regret a lot of the actions we've taken this period. I also feel sad because this is still my dad. And I would be devastated if our bond would be nothing to my dad if he finds out I'm not his biological kid. Now for the top advice. If it was my dad, I'd do the test. I'd want to know too. OP, your mom had a 12-year-long affair. That's longer than most marriages. And there's no way your dad won't need a paternity test. Your mom had the nerve to divorce first to say her piece first. Essentially, she never cared for your father. Your dad loves you and his son. The hate and rejection he may express is more to do with the fact your mother humiliated, debased, and lied to him for what is essentially his entire life, and regarding the things he cared for the most. Every time your brother called your father dad, every birthday they spent together. Throughout your mother's pregnancy, while your brother was sick, while they spent time together as father and son, your mother knew the truth, and I'd bet her boss knew too. Your dad sacrificed time, effort, mental well-being, and considerable money to support his family. And the only reason the affair stopped is because your mom was effectively dumped. What could be more humiliating to your dad? He has been played for a fool most of his life. So if he lashes out at you and your brother, it's because he is vulnerable, hating that he loves what was used against him. If he carries on as normal, he feels he is giving your mother what she wants without her ever receiving justice. Your paternal grandparents, uncles, aunts, your cousins were all duped. If your brother has children, they also won't be biologically related to him. Your mother has carried out an intergenerational deceit. Even your brother was left in the dark. Has he been told? Give your money to your dad and tell him to use it for your brother. Cutting out your mother from the equation will make it more palatable for him. Has your mom shown any remorse? Guilt? Regret? How does she justify what she did? What consequences has she faced? This entire situation is due to the selfish actions of one individual. Her actions have damaged your father's relationships, but he still loves you and your brother. His ties to you are stronger than her lies. In my opinion, your best bet at maintaining a relationship with him, regardless of the results of any test, is to unilaterally and immediately cut your mom out of your life before the test. He needs to see you take his feelings seriously. Empathize first and foremost with your father. Show him you care, and he will be more amenable to helping your brother, especially if your mom pays a price for her betrayal. He deserves the right to know as you do. You both only know the lies your mother has told you, and this is the key bit, so far. Specifically, she had what reads as a 12-year affair. 12 years? And shows no remorse. Most of your dad's entire adult life and half his family are a lie. He deserves to know. And so do you. I agree, but also wanted to add, OP, you gotta go to therapy, and so do your dad and your brother. I'd suggest telling him you'll take the test if he commits to going to therapy, which you will pay for, including a requirement that he go to some therapy sessions before you take the test, including maybe a joint therapy session with you, where you can tell him you understand how hard this is, and you love him no matter what, and want to be in his life no matter what. And you need to go to therapy before you take the test too. Now for the last story. I messed up by hooking my girlfriend up with a job at a company I work for. Happened years ago, but I was told to post this here. My girlfriend, at the time, and I were dating for just shy of 6 years. We were high school sweethearts and still in school. She'd always struggled with jobs and keeping them, and since we lived together, I usually had to pick up the slack. I was working as an assistant manager at a video game retail store at the time, probably not hard to figure out which one. It was honestly an easy job as long as you gave little effort. Pre-orders here, couple of warranty sales there. And as my girlfriend loved video games more than I did, I had a brilliant idea to get her a job. She's an attractive girl, while 80% of our customers were neckbeards who hardly get to interact with women. Should be easy for her to make sales. There's no way she can mess this up, I said, confidently to myself. There is a policy, as of most companies, that people in relationships can't work at the same location. No problem. We have 12 stores in our district that are within a 5-mile radius, but they seriously put these stores on every other block. I do a little digging, and hook her up at a neighboring store that had a vacant position. She would also be working with the head store manager of the district, and directly one of my bosses. Few weeks in, and it's going great. It took me about a year to get moved up, she dozen weeks. I'm not a self-conscious person, so I didn't care. Plus, she could help pick up her half of the bills. Here's where I started to realize I messed up. Girlfriend comes driving in with a brand new car. Considering we were living paycheck to paycheck, I was pretty upset. I asked her where she got the car from, and she told me I've been saving up. BS, but okay. I loved her, so as long as she's happy, I'm happy. Next comes in with write-ups. I started getting write-ups and customer complaints left and right. I'm a very good employee, and I very rarely make anyone upset. And I couldn't even find where these customers were coming from. Even though my performance was the best out of most employees, I was starting to fear for my job. And as to be predicted, I ended up getting fired. I try to fight it, but I live in Texas, and the rules are that companies can fire anyone at any time for any reason. I'm absolutely crushed. I turn to my girlfriend for emotional support, only to find her extremely distant. She dumped me days later. Double whammy. I loved her for 6 years. She told me she felt this way for a while. Things are the same. I'm absolutely heartbroken. I'm angry, depressed, jobless. Felt like my life got flipped upside down. 1 week later, her Facebook status put her in a relationship with her boss. My boss. Not sure when it happened, but he bought her a car and then got me fired. Turns out, all the customer complaints about me originated from that store somehow. Total BS. I set her up to absolutely screw me over and to bone my boss. Edit. Perhaps the biggest screw-up is the fact I didn't sue. I was such an emotional wreck from everything that it didn't even cross my mind. But I'm doing pretty well for myself now, and whatever money I'd get would be worth bringing her to court for. Just the thought of seeing her sends chill down my spine. Now for the top comments before the little update. Damn, like she couldn't just leave you? For what reason did that guy have to get you fired first? I can't imagine how you were feeling after that. She probably got his old job since she couldn't suck up to her boss and work at the same location as him. Damn, now I'm sad. For those asking why sad, I appreciate that Opie's doing better now and I'm happy for him, truly. I wrote the original comments prior to edits detailing his happiness and moving on. Not only that though, I'm going through something similar to his story. I'm sure the moment of impact was awful and his suffering was intense at the time. Still, I'm glad things have gotten better. She sounds crazy. Better it happened now than later, when you were married and she tries to take half your stuff. Yeah, this happened for a reason. Andy dodged a bullet there. Update. A couple of you guys were wondering, but they dated a few months and broke it off. Neither of them work for the company anymore. A little detail I forgot to mention that when she came to take her stuff from our place, he was helping carry the stuff to her car. That was probably the most gut-wrenching moment for me. Both of them are POS. I really appreciate all the positive feedback. I've been mostly over it, but the love really helps. Some of you guys are asking where she's now. She's doing alright. She's engaged to one of my old high school friends. Also slightly suspicious. Still driving the same car too, from the looks of it. I'm doing pretty well for myself. But if there's any happy ending to this, it's that I'm genuinely happier than I've ever been in my life. Again, I really appreciate the positive messages. Reliving and retelling the story made me angry and I missed a few details. I can't prove that he bought her a car, but I was pretty aware of her finances, and she couldn't afford a new car without significant help. It wasn't a fancy car. It was a new Prius that was worth about $18,000 in addition to trading in her old car. And the rumor around the block was that he did, in fact, help her. I was not a perfect boyfriend. I got upset at silly things. I could have been more attentive, but I never raised my voice, and I was very loyal. But the course of when she got promoted to when she got the car was roughly 3 to 4 months. The separation and firing happened about 2 months after that. I didn't clarify that detail. The boss was a DM in training, recently got promoted, and the kind of guy that would spend money to impress a girl.